So I'm Clemens Kaminski, and I'm the director of the sensor CDT for sensor technologies. This is an exciting time for us now because we are in the second phase of the CDT. And what we do in this new CDT is we want to see how we can use sensor technologies to really make a change and to address global challenges that will become pertinent things of the future. So we are fortunate to be able to attract top talent, fantastic students who come from different cultures and with different skills and with different expertise, and together they really achieve amazing things. They travel out into the world and they make technology and apply it in ways that really make a difference to the future.
So my name is Farah, Alimagham. My PhD focuses on the development and design of mid-infrared sensor systems and devices. Some of them involve volatile organic compound sensing and continuous monitoring of biofluids, which has great potential in the medical field. A key aspect of the sensor CDT, and something that I find is wonderful, is that you are automatically involved in this fantastic network of people.
My name is Sebastian. My research is about bio and electrolyte sensing using the fringe fields of a capacitive sensor. What I like about the sensor CDT is I think it enables us to explore research in a more multidisciplinary way.
I've really enjoyed talking to the new students and seeing the diversity of the students that we can attract to the CDT. What I really like is the idea of a sort of a group mind, so we get students from all kinds of disciplines, all the way from biology through to computer science, and when they tackle a problem, they tackle it together, and so you get some very creative solutions to some problems that we pose them. A unique feature of the CDT is the idea that they are thinking about sensors as an underlying technology, but the application can be in all kinds of really diverse ways. So thinking about the idea of sensors as a sort of a commodity almost, but thinking about how to deploy them. Now we're bringing in a responsible innovation, so thinking from the outset, how am I going to deploy these sensors in a way that is going to have a meaningful impact, not just economically, but also to society and to environment in a lot of cases. So we have students come in to do a Masters of Research in the first year, and then they embark on a three-year PhD. The nice thing is that they come in and they get to explore all kinds of different subjects, which means that they can really make an informed decision about what kind of a PhD they'd like to do. We have over 40 different departments around Cambridge in all kinds of different disciplines, including social sciences and things like philosophy. So you could really do an interesting PhD in a subject that you might never have thought about before you came here.
Hello, I'm Johanna. I'm a PhD student working on terahertz spectroscopy. The first year of my PhD program was actually a master's year that was done as an MRes with the sensor CDT. So we had lectures about all kinds of sensing and how that applies to almost every aspect of science. That was really interesting, and it allowed to explore directions and disciplines that we hadn't heard about before.
The sensor CDT program starts with a Master of Research in your first year, which is designed to teach you all the skills and knowledge that will support you and make your PhD, the second phase of the program, successful. So what we want to teach in the first year is that students understand how to make sensors from physical principles, integrate them into bigger systems, and understand the applications that they can be used for. Well, the sensor CDT is looking for a broad range of backgrounds, mostly in the STEM subjects. So we have in the program people from electronic engineering, chemistry, physics, biochemistry, all of these different fields. The type of people we're looking for are committed, engaged, motivated to go outside their comfort zone, to engage with topics that you might not have engaged with during your undergrad degree, and also people who love to work in teams. We have quite a strong team aspect in the sensor CDT. When you join the sensor CDT, be unafraid. We trust our students. We trust them to be able to run projects by themselves, and we trust them to run their initiatives after that. And that trust we've seen building confidence in the students to be able to be change makers in the world.
We've got a lot of industrial contacts that we're bringing to the students, that we open the dialogue between industrial partners to pitch problems to students, but also where we allow students to go out and explore problems that industry is presenting in the format of short talks or presentations that industrialists provide, and then give them the opportunity to work together on a research project.
My name is Chris, I'm a second year PhD student. My research project is about formulating new nanocarriers for DNA vaccines, and I do that together with AstraZeneca. I think the CDT is all about diversity and different backgrounds, bring people together from different nationalities. We all benefit from that, in particular in a scientific context, because we work together with physicists, biologists, chemists, and they all mixed up together in the CDT. I already had a few collaborations coming from being in the CDT, actually.
I'm Lara, Allan. I'm the CEO of the Centre for Global Equality, which is a not-for-profit based in Cambridge that focuses on inclusive innovation. We define inclusive innovation as innovation by, with, and for the rising billions. Or another way of saying that is the bottom half of the world's population that lives on less than $4 a day. The reason to go to developing countries and to co-create this new version of those sensors with people on the ground is to make sure it's appropriate to the context. We are working on a co-creation process of iteratively testing sensors with end users, so with scientists and technologists in country. We have a global network of international development practitioners, small grassroots organizations and big multilaterals. And we spend a lot of time sourcing challenges. We look for problems and then try to match those problems with the interests and the capacities of particular groups. I'm also really excited about last year's CDT project, SoliCam. They've been working on the really very difficult project of soil quality, which turned out to be much more complicated than any of us thought it was going to be. But they've evolved a very good, interesting soil moisture sensor and are working on that, continue to working on that. We hope are going to be testing it with our colleagues in Ethiopia. I just wanted to say that the logo, which is an echo of the colors and the wheel of the UN Sustainable Development Goals, that logo really is for real. The people who are involved are really committed to this, and I'm very excited about the possibilities of what's going to come out of the CDT over the next 5 years.
As an environmental organization, we depend on sensors in order to collect the data about environmental change and then work with that data for interpretations that help us to adapt to what the future will bring. So we have a great interest in working with the early career scientists and the Census CDT. It's a fantastic group of people from so many different backgrounds who have come together to learn as a cohort, and that diversity of backgrounds is a real asset, because the cross-fertilization between these different disciplines means that you can make real step changes. What the CDT offers is a rounded learning experience, and the students who have the privilege of working in it come out as people who have not only got a very narrow set of expertise that they bring to the workplace, but they bring a much, much broader picture with them. The teams have achieved through measuring air quality, first here in a local context, then on a European scale, and taking that to Africa and to South America as well, has been truly astounding. And I'm particularly grateful for the aspect that the focus is on and using that expertise to ensure that we are able to tackle the sustainability goals and use this tech for good indeed. I'm particularly excited to know that this fantastically diverse and creative cohort of students is able to use that creativity and that skill to think about solutions for the big challenge that we face as a planet to meet zero carbon 2050 goals and to stay within 1.5 degrees global warming. So it is absolutely essential that each and every one of us look at what we can bring to the table. And the subject matter that the students are dealing with is extremely helpful. And again, that rounded approach of looking at many different disciplines and bringing increasingly also social science into it and citizen science and interacting with very tangibly with real world problems as the team challenges have done is a fantastic platform. So I very much look forward to what will come out of the interaction between this CDT and Cambridge University's Zero Carbon Initiative and with the broader move towards making sure that each and everyone employ our creativity, our skills to become part of the solution.
So we're looking for students who are really driven to address global challenges with technology. If you're motivated, if you like working in team, if you are excited about sensor technologies and how they can be used in a responsible and novel context, then this program is for you. And I would be very, very pleased to welcome you into our program.